Über die Stichworte Klagenfurt, unkonventioneller Grindcore, abstrakte Lyrik, surreale Kunst kommen wir nun zur nächsten Band. Die Rede ist von Disharmonic Orchestra aus Klagenfurt, deren aktuelles Album in den Sunlight Studios in Stockholm entstand. Das Cover-Artwork, gewohnt surreal gehalten, ist im Hintergrund eingeblendet. Und von diesem Album werdet ihr einen Song hören, der euch die Fortschritte der Band deutlich machen soll, die bemüht ist, mit Rap-Anleihen, Akustikpassagen und Ähnlichem einen unverwechselbaren Sound zu kreieren. Viel Spaß damit.
Yeah. Jeff Ickes, bassist, vocalist for the band Brutality. Brutality's been around since 1986. In 1990, he did a three-song 7-inch Nuclear Blast reference, which sold really well. You can still get it in the underground. Now we're getting ready to do another two-song 7-inch Nuclear Blast for our debut album, which will hopefully be out by the end of the year. And now, to the rest of the band at Jesus Records.
Say hi, guys. Introduce yourselves from left to right over here.
I'm Scott Regal. I'm vocalist, lead vocalist.
I'm John Gates, lead guitar, rhythm guitar.
Jim Coker plays drums.
I'm Jay Fernandez, lead guitar, rhythm guitar.
Very cool. Now that everybody knows who you are, what has been happening with Brutality in the past few months?
Record deal.
Record deal with who?
Finally,
yeah.
Nuclear Blast.
Right now, that's right. How'd that come about?
Our manager has talked to him.
Very good manager. Set us up to send him some promotion.
Very good demo.
Very good demo.
More sound demo.
Definitely.
But,
yeah, it looks really good. They're giving us a good deal. So we're real happy about that.
All the cheeseburgers you need, huh?
Yeah.
We've liked a lot of their products, you know, that they've done before. You know, I like a lot of the bands they've had on their
What are some of the influences in Brutality?
From Carcass to
a lot of different kind of music.
Everybody's got their own different influences.
Hey, okay, start with you. If I go to your house, I'm going to find your record collection.
Oh, God. Al Di Meola, Alan Holdsworth, Morbid Angel, Carcass. Anything from jazz to death metal.
What if I go to your house and go through your records?
I got all sorts of just
Al
Di Meola.
Yeah, I got Al Di Meola, Punch and Pinch, you know, I got it all. The heavy, all the good heavy stuff. I like a lot of different stuff, you know.
Same question for you.
Ball thrower.
Who are my favorites?
I have to say probably anything from Mob Angel to Dark Throat.
He likes country, boo.
Clint Black.
Country music.
Country man.
Lighter stuff.
Your record collection.
From Doom to black metal to Beethoven or Mozart, whatever.
That's it.
Very cool. Let's get back to the record deal. When are you guys going to go record a record and get it out to the public so they can experience Brutality?
We start recording in December of 92. It should be out by March.
Where are you going to record at?
More Sound.
Of course.
The only place with Jim Morris, the heaviest.
Yeah.
Death metal scene has grown so big so quickly that it's quite hard for too many bands to survive this. I think the strongest bands and the most experienced bands will survive, put more albums out, becoming bigger like Slayer or Metallica in a few years. But the weak bands that started off perhaps half a year ago, 1 year ago, will die quite soon. Most of the fans that are coming around right now don't know anything about underground. They buy the records, but don't know about the demos and all the tape train that was the beginning of this scene at all. And I think the underground will be quite dead in a few years also, if there would not be another wave of people that are really interested in writing and trading. Well, I think we're a fancy band, but I mean, it's always a little bit, not like a joke, but almost like a joke behind it, because if somebody takes this too seriously, then we quite want it, because I think you have to be a little bit more happy about life. You can't be angry with everything you see. I mean, more important things like war and everything, everybody just let that through and don't care about it, but things like a record cover is very upsetting for people. I think that's quite wrong. That's what we're trying to show with this. Well, the Carnage album was after Dismember split up, I went into a band called Carnage with Mike Lamott, who's now in Carcass, and we recorded an album together with Matti, who went from Carbonized into Carnage, and David, who went back from Entombed after a while. When we recorded this album, Michael went off to join Carcass, so we just changed the name, me, Matti, and David. And that was it. Just a record that is still dismembered, because it's only half the record is only dismembered songs.
Die winterliche Umgebung von Donzdorf ähnelt trotz alledem sehr stark der winterlichen Landschaft Schwedens, der Heimat der folgenden Band Dismember. Ihr seht den Videoclip Soon to be Dead von der ersten LP, der wird auf der demnächst erscheinenden 12-Inch drauf sein. Dieser Videoclip ist an eine Station verschickt worden, niemand war bereit ihn zu senden. Ihr werdet gleich sehen warum, macht euch selbst euer Bild. Hier kommt Soon to be Dead, viel Spaß.
Populär in der Heimat gilt Revenant derzeit in Deutschland und Europa als unterbewertetster Act des härtesten Genres. Ihr werdet einen Videoclip zu sehen bekommen, der mitgeschnitten wurde auf der 91er Europa-Tournee von Revenant gemeinsam mit Gorefest in der Hamburger Markthalle. Dabei viel Spaß.
Midnight, I grew identity, subterranean descent into Atomic reasoning creates uncertain distances between reality and consciousness. Temporal existence disintegrates into micromolecular infinity. Representations of ideas cloud eternal skies beyond the mind's eye. Shadow. Electrification.
Let this sleep. 20 meter van de markt.
Dass man über die Bandpanel Stand aus Wien noch viele einleitende Worte verlieren muss. Mit einem überaus provokanten Image und recht geschmackvollen Covergestaltung sind sie doch allen Teilen im Gespräch gewesen. Ich denke dabei vor allen Dingen an das Coverartwork des Debüts, ihr entsinnt euch an die abgeschnittenen Gliedmaßen. Auch das zweite Album ist nicht von schlechten Eltern mit diesen ineinander verschlungenen Greisen. Es erinnert mich an ein altes Brezhnev-Honecker-Foto. Okay, sicherlich kann man über die Covergestaltung geteilter Meinung sein. Einig waren sich die Death Metal und Grindcore-Fans sicherlich allenthalben, dass die Musik, die auf beiden Platten geboten wurde, Death Metal und Grindcore vom Allerfeinsten ist. Viel Spaß damit. We'll be right back. Ich hoffe, es hat euch gefallen und euch genauso viel Spaß gemacht wie uns bei der Entstehung dieses Streifens. Ihr könnt euch schon freuen, es wird in diesem Jahr noch eine Fortsetzung dieses Teils geben, der dann wahrscheinlich, das ist zwar kaum vorstellbar, sogar noch erheblich professioneller ausfallen wird. Lasst euch überraschen. Bis dann, macht's gut. Tschüssi.
That's not all. You know, got this nice thing with a man I worked with for some years. But forget about that. You know, this is my favorite one. I wear it in my leisure time. But I wear this for professional use, you know? So, if you'd like to order, you know what this is? You know what this is? And you can get it, man. You won't get it for free. All I ask is the IRC, you know, cause nothing in life is ever for free. So check it out.